Hi, welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Marcus Yam, and today we've got some exciting news on 12th gen Intel Core processors, codenamed Alder Lake. Now, some thought that we were done with the entire family, but there is one more processor coming into the lineup. Joining me today is Dan Rogers, Senior Director at Intel's Client Group. Dan, thanks for joining me, and you're here to tell me about a new member of the family. But before we get started, I want to show you. I had this eye chart made, and I know at Intel sometimes we joke that our presentations can look like eye charts. So I made this for the family, for S for desktop, H for mobile enthusiast, U and P for ultra mobile. But there's one thing I'm missing here, right?
Yeah, there's one additional letter we need to add today, Marcus. Here we're here to update and expand our H series product line.
All right, so what's the letter I'm missing?
The letter we're missing is X for expanded H series. Okay. And today we're here to talk about our new product line, purpose built for mobile workstations.
Okay, so H and HX. What's the relationship and what's the difference?
HX is really a product that we built specifically for professionals in the field who need low latency access to data for their entire working data set in their computer to do very computational tasks in the field or on location.
Now I have, I so happen to have an HX here. That's HX. And here is a desktop, Alder Lake S. What's the relationship between these two?
Right, you'll see they're very similar. You'll immediately notice the similarities here with a couple of key differences. So while the XY, the ball out or the signal out is very similar, delivering a huge amount of IO to the platform, you'll also notice that the chip is similar, except one is with the backside metallization and a lid, and the other is bare, designed for a notebook.
What are the advantages of going from this BGA design compared to the desktop chip?
It's all about the Z height. So our socket's just over 4 millimeters, and the BGA package here on our HX product line is about 2 millimeters. And this is key in order to fit into a thin notebook form factor with appropriate cooling.
And what other commonalities are there between the desktop and HX?
Yeah, so we've taken the same great compute and optimized that for a mobile power level. And we've also leveraged the huge amount of I/O, both on the CPU as well as with the discrete chipset, in order to maximize the amount of data transfer in the notebook.
And in terms of core count, is it the same configuration up and down the stack? Because this one is a 8P core and 8E cores.
That's right. We're happy to announce this is a 16-core processor, the world's first 16-core notebook, actually, which is a huge amount of compute, 24 threads, and will really break some barriers in performance.
And that's the relationship between S and HX. I've got a H here as well. And this one I noticed there's PCH right on the chip. It's not here. So what's the difference in IO available between H versus HX?
Sure, our H series, you can see it's a bit more tailored, and we've done that to fit into 14-inch, 15-inch, 16-inch smaller form factor designs. This HX processor is really all about maximum amount of IO, so it's got a little bit more legroom in there. And because of that space, we're able to increase the number of cores and increase the number of signals, increasing memory, increasing storage, and increasing bandwidth to the chip.
Then what is performance like? You're talking a lot about more I/O, more cores. Tell me about performance.
Yeah, this is really an incredibly performant processor. 55-watt base power specification delivers 10 to 20% more multi-threaded performance versus our 12900HK, and up to 80% faster than the previous generation.
Going back to core count, H goes up to 6 plus 8. That's 6P cores, 8E cores. Why the decision to push it even further? And why not just make a 8P core, 8E core version of H? Why have to move it to the desktop die for HX?
Sure. So as you can see in our H series, it's really shrink-wrapped. It's form-fitted in there. And that's really optimum for a 45-watt power envelope, even slightly lower, down to 35 watts. HX is about delivering the best possible I/O plus performance. So we take advantage of the additional space to deliver the full 16 cores, increasing performance, as well as the additional space for signals to deliver a full 2 DIMM per channel DDR5, up to 128 gig, and up to 4 SSDs. You can imagine 8, yeah. 16 terabytes of storage in your notebook immediately available to you. So you don't need to keep your project on the cloud. You can keep your entire project right in your notebook.
And you're talking a lot about I/O. That's an off-chip PCH. One of the hallmark features of Alder Lake S and now HX is PCIe Gen 5 support. Mm-hmm. What does that mean for this segment? What workloads really demand that extra bandwidth?
Sure, so we're excited to bring PCIe Gen 5 as well, a full 16 lanes of Gen 5. And this is future-proofing for upcoming GPUs in the future, but also enables the new SSDs that are coming into market today. So many of our notebooks, some of which you see behind us here, these notebooks will be ready to go with support for Gen 5 SSDs today, doubling the bandwidth versus Gen 4.
Yeah, that's actually really interesting because I know on the GPU side, generally these designs have soldered GPUs as well, but in this form factor, you have modularity with SSDs. So for those who want to configure with Gen 5 SSD, that option's there. You mentioned up to four SSDs. So anyone who has high demands for storage, RAID configurations, this sounds like the perfect platform for those addicted to storage.
Yeah, workstations blur the lines between a desktop and a notebook. They offer notebook portability, but desktop class configurability and I/O. So many of our systems will have two, three, four SSDs, not just for massive capacity, but also for redundancy. And Gen 5 is a key technology to enable that best-in-class storage.
So HX, I noticed, has a processor-based power of 55 watts. Now, it is derived from the desktop die, which on the desktop side, we're seeing up to 150 watts processor-based power. But we've seen, you told me, about great performance at 55 watts. What does that mean for dialing things down, or at least right-sizing them for the mobile space? 55 watts, is there any performance that's being left on the table?
Well, it speaks to the flexibility of this architecture, right? It started with desktop and then we brought it to mobile. And here we're now bringing the same die from desktop all the way to mobile. And it speaks to the two different dynamic range of the chip. We can have absolute high frequencies for the best possible performance in a desktop form factor. And then we take the same CPU layout, but we optimize that both on the process and on the design side to deliver mobile class efficiency and performance together.
You mentioned higher frequency. For those who want even more frequency, higher frequencies, the entire HX line is unlocked for overclocking.
It is.
Which is interesting, right? Because usually unlocked processors are something that are reserved for the gamers or the enthusiasts. Mm-hmm. But this segment, HX, could really be for those working on mission-critical applications, which typically you wouldn't think of in that flexibility with unlocked processors. So can you tell me about that decision to have unlocked processors for this segment?
Yeah, generally we don't think about stability and overclocking as going hand in hand. And this brings us to a different application for our HX processor line, which is gaming. Many laptops, actually the two behind us here, will actually be used in gaming systems as well to deliver the best possible performance. Our HK is actually still the world's best gaming processor. HX is a great gaming processor as well. And we've enabled overclocking in the entire SKU stack so that our partners can offer overclocked memory faster than our specification right out of the box. All HX processors are overclockable.
So you mentioned memory. I know another great hallmark of 12th gen is the expansive memory support through the entire family. But HX brings it one step further with ECC memory support. Can you tell me about, you know, what that is and who should be looking out for systems that have ECC memory?
Sure. So when you're working with large data sets, which is what workstations are all about, data integrity and data redundancy are critical. So we have RAID on the storage side, and we also offer ECC or error correcting code on the memory side, both DDR4 and DDR5, to ensure that we avoid any kind of silent data corruptions or errors that would impact, obviously, mission critical applications.
And mission critical systems generally reserved for the Intel Xeon product line. Given that this feature is now on HX, is HX the new Xeon?
We simplified the brand structure a bit. So this generation will have the Core brand in the gaming systems and the vPro brand in our mobile workstations.
So vPro, mission critical, makes a lot of sense with ECC on it. But going back to overclocking, there's overclocking on vPro systems too, but at a different level. Why the difference between a vPro overclocking system, capability system, compared to the rest of the lineup?
So all of the HX processors, as we mentioned, offer some level of overclocking, full memory overclocking up and down the stack. And for the processors that are focused on gaming, the 12800HX and the 12900HX, they offer a full overclock up on the cores, unlimited frequency capability based on what the silicon can do. And this is for users who really want to push the limits of the device.
And memory overclocking, right? There's some really cool technologies for that. There's a dynamic memory boost and Intel Speed Optimizer. All of these things are available throughout the entire HX lineup. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, we've updated all of our tools to support DDR5 as well as the new hybrid architecture.
I'm coming back to the core configuration, right? Because clearly if you want 8 plus 8, 16 cores, it's HX. But if you're looking for a little bit of a different configuration, let's say you're looking for 6P cores, 8E cores, that configuration is available on H series. So there is the same core configuration between H and HX, and some other ones too. There's like a 4 plus 8 and a 4 plus 4. What's the deciding factor for where someone should get an H series system compared to an HX system with a similar configuration?
It's a great question. There's something for everybody in 12th gen. You'll notice in the core counts, there's an upgrade from H to HX. With additional power, a bit additional real estate in the package, we're able to increase core counts at every brand level. But the key distinguishing factor between an H-series processor and an HX processor is really about big data. I/O, compute, storage, these are processors that are designed to handle massive amounts of data, both in memory and in storage, and out of the system through Thunderbolt 4.
Now, these systems are pretty exciting, and I know there are many more. Are these going to be offered by all OEMs? Is this more of a limited release part? And is there going to be a mix between workstation and gaming designs?
There is. We're expecting to see both mobile workstations and gaming systems for all of our major partners.
And these big computationally intense tasks, they typically leverage both high-end CPUs as well as discrete graphics.
That's right.
So are all these systems going to be paired with discrete graphics?
Correct. All HX systems will ship with discrete graphics, both from Intel as well as third party. And these discrete graphics systems and platforms that ship with HX often are certified to ensure reliability and a high quality user experience with the key professional applications so that there's no disruption to your workflow.
Do those discrete options include Intel Arc graphics?
They do.
HX was, I'm gonna have to update this eye chart to add that little HX in there, but is this going to be a mainstay for mobile platforms going forward, at least in the near future? Or is this kind of like a one-time thing for 12th gen?
Well, the demand for compute continues to grow and data is only getting bigger. So although this is a very focused segment, it's super important to us at Intel, and we continue to invest in this segment going forward.
Well, that's a lot of information. These are just two of the many systems coming. I can't wait to see more. Do you have any more like closing thoughts? What should people really take away about HX?
Well, we're super proud of our entire 12th gen family, starting with desktop and then our H series we launched at CES, our thin and light processors, our P series and our U series. And now we've sort of saved the best for last on the mobile side here, bringing this brand new HX processor line. We're really excited about what we've been able to achieve this generation, and we have even more to show later in the year.
Great. Well, Dan, thanks for joining me on Talking Tech. Really exciting. And can't wait to do this again.
Thanks, Marcus.
All right, thank you.